mic quickly.
What do you think, Nico? Your prediction?
Tommy's going to win.
Really?
This is an outstanding...
Because that's your coach.
Yeah. I feel like constrained here in the seat, but who doesn't know Jake Paul? Really? Like, even my... Really? Oh, come on. You guys have no clue who he is. Of course, of course. The one thing we don't know about him, or most people don't know about him, is that he has a huge heart. Jake has done outstanding work with the community, with kids, working against bullying. I think he's one of the few promoters that actually split promoter fighter that takes away from his own purse to split it among the fighters in his undercard. And I think that's very, very heartfelt. And I am so proud to present to you Mr. Jake Paul. Look at you! Wait. Wait. Okay, so I'm all for surprises. Where's my man BJ Flores, man?
Oh, BJ's here.
Where's BJ?
BJ's right here.
Oh, there you go. Hey. Yeah.
You know.
How you doing? And Coach D. Are you handing the baton? What's up with that? What?
We're building the dream team, you know? And we had to bring in a secret weapon.
Okay. This opens a whole can of worms, completely different kind of worms. It's so good to have you here.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. It's good to be here in Vegas. Shout out to the people watching at home. Another one. Here we go.
We're going to talk a little bit about Coach T. I need to know how and when and why.
Well, I take it from you, Jake.
Ooh!
I've been doing this for about 40 years.
But you're almost 25.
Well, you know, things happen. I've been through a lot. You know, I was around during Tyson time. You know, I saw something in the white boy. I made sure I made it happen. So, we here.
There you go. So, when did you decide to touch base with Coach T?
You know, after the Woodley fight, I came out, I reassessed my performance. And I was like, you know what, I did great. I beat a 5-time UFC champion. I took his hardest punch that he won the UFC championship with, like it was nothing. I was off balance. You know, it's boxing. You're gonna get dirty if you're a mechanic. But I was like, you know, there's some things we can tighten up. And that's where, you know, started making some calls, and that's where Coach D came in. And you know, it's been a game changer.
So Coach D is actually an advisor to BJ.
Well, I wouldn't say that. I came in for nourishment, and you know, he wasn't making weight, so I made sure he made weight. We came in. I continued to tell him. I said, "Come with that right jab under that belt." He listened. He's a good boy. Like I said, you know, don't fall too far from the tree. I talked to his papa. His papa's a good guy. Yeah, we just working.
Well, I look forward to see you performing December 18th.
And look, I mean, Tommy went and got Sugar Hill, you know. Tommy went and, you know, getting Tyson to be in his corner. So, what am I going to do? I have a response to that, you know. This is a serious business. Life is on the line.
Okay, so now I'm going to change gears now that you said life is on the line. Many times you've said boxing saved your life. How did the sport save your life?
Man, I was a young kid in Los Angeles, just getting caught up in the wrong things, surrounded by the wrong group of people, and boxing gave me the chance to take my life back and to follow a routine and to work on something and to have a purpose, and it gave me something to fight for. I wasn't meant for LA, although I thought I was. Boxing is my true home. And it took me until I was 21 years old to find that, you know. But some of the greatest fighters don't find out they're fighters until they're a little bit older. Deontay Wilder, the list goes on.
Before we go any further, I need to just acknowledge the presence of Problem Bob right there. Thank you, Problem Bob. Ooh, yeah. Is that your security?
Yeah, he's got an RPG.
You know, a lot of people talk about what you do outside the ring. Obviously, you've been an influencer all your life, even before influencers were, you know, famous and the thing to do and trending. But there's a lot more to you. I just gave a little bit of snippets of what you do for the community. First of all, talk to us about that commitment with against bullying and children, just in general.
Yeah, look, I want to use my platform for good. Ever since I was young, you know, my dad, who's here today, shout out Greg Paul, we would always go and give back, volunteering, handing out food on Thanksgiving, whatever it was, we always wanted to get involved in the community. And I had a dream as a kid to have a foundation, have a charity, and now I'm, you know, finally at a place where I felt like I was able to give back and to use my platform to give back. And that's why I'm passionate about Boxing Bullies, my foundation, and fighting back against bullying, because I once was a bully and I realized it wasn't cool. And then I got cyber bullied by my peers and friends when I started to post videos online. And I was like, wow, these comments hurt. And I realized this is a big problem in our generation, and cyberbullying affects so many people. And I think boxing gives people confidence, you know, to not have to feel like they need to pull other people down or to just be themselves. And that's what it did for me. And so I want to be able to share boxing and this message just with the whole entire world. And I think everyone should take up the sport, even just for fitness, confidence, and being able to protect yourself.
Mental health, key. Thank you for that. But talking about the sport itself, I get a chance to speak to fighters all the time, and the one thing they always say is boxing is a very jealous wife. It doesn't like to share their time, doesn't like to share their men. You spread yourself out so thin that I wonder, how deep is your commitment to the sport itself?
I'll take this one.
Thank you, Coach.
I'd probably say, you know, this kid right here, we've been coaching him. He's been a smart kid, he's a good boy, like I said. He can fight. At the end of the day, if it ain't about fighting, it ain't about a motherfucking thing. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I brought him in, he gonna fight. We tried to get your brother, didn't we?
Yeah.
We tried to get his brother.
Yep.
His brother was running.
Yep.
I talked to Tyson. Tyson was running. I talked to Sugar Ray Leonard. He was running. So now, you know, we trying to find people where we can fight and have a good, decent fight where we got in front of us. You know what I'm saying? So.
It's a lot of work.
But that's why I have the best team. You know?